So today, we are exploring two homes that will be showing us the use of color and texture.
Anton, tell me, what is your take on color?
Well, Steph, I feel that color really adds a lot of depth and dimension to a space.
While I am more of a neutral kind of girl, I do like color, but I feel like it's important to kind of build up the palettes, you know, like work with two or three colors first and then build up the confidence and go for the bolder colors afterwards.
So you're saying start conservatively
and exactly.
Then just go all out.
Little by little, taking baby steps.
Okay, well I, on the other hand, I like deep dark colors because I feel it makes the room expansive. Contrary to popular belief, they say that dark colors maybe like make the room smaller.
Oh yes, that's true.
I disagree. I feel it expands the room.
Oh, that's so interesting.
Well, depth, right? Color, there's depth in color.
Exactly. And how about texture? I love seeing texture in furniture designs. I love seeing more than one material in a piece. It just, like you said, brings out so much depth and it just makes the furniture design so much more interesting.
Well, my take on texture is like, when we all say your home is representative of you, it shows your personality. So when you have textures, one over the other, nuances, layers, then it gives personality to what you have around in the house.
It's also part of the senses, right? Textures, like what you feel, something smooth, something rough. It's good for the senses.
Yes, and it helps visual, like visual stimulation. You get excited. Then you know when you focus on something, it makes you feel like you're transported.
So I'm very curious to see what we are going to discover in the next two homes today.
I'm sure that all of you viewers will be excited because we have great homes lined up for you.
So today I'm going to check out an apartment designed by Cynthia Almario.
And I'm going to walk you through a home designed by Tanya Frike-Lichauco. Steph, what are you expecting to see from the Almario project?
Well, from what I know of the Almario sisters, they really stick to their motifs and they have a cohesive approach to every project. From architectural details to styling the accessories, I'm expecting something pretty bold and well put together.
Yes, they work with color so well.
So what are you expecting from Tanya's home?
I've known Tanya for quite some time and I know that she's so good at mixing materials. She likes to layer textures as well and she leans towards a lighter palette. So
okay.
I'm excited to see this.
I'm excited to see the mix of styles in both homes. I'm very curious to see what we're going to stumble upon today.
Displays a variety of styles, Filipino antiques, oriental, and the contemporary, while boasting vibrant colors and textures and patterns, all mixed and matched tastefully. Let's have a look.
This home is newly renovated. After 7 years, the owners decided to give it a complete overhaul. As we enter the home, we are greeted with a striking blue wall with a cool composition of different mirrors and a painting. This bold grouping is complemented by a picture-perfect tableau of different objects anchored by a pair of brass and lucite lamps. The open plan boasts of a gracious space that unifies the living and the dining room, making it easy and comfortable to move around. The living room's sunset color scheme calms the senses. A mix of fabric, patterns, and texture give the room a relaxing vibe. There's an unexpected but exciting addition to the living room, a pair of modern lighting fixtures that literally and figuratively light up the room. A custom-made eye-catching carpet in blue with linear borders define the space. Beside the living room, a set of accordion-type doors are dressed in Solohia weave. They open up to reveal a cozy sitting room. This multi-use space is used as an entertainment room or to escape and enjoy some quiet time after a long day. The dining room echoes the same contemporary and eclectic feel. The dining chairs were upcycled and given a new look. The backrests were lowered and the arms were added for a more relaxed and laid-back feel. The addition of an accent chair plus a pair of ottomans below the buffet make this diningscape an inviting and sociable space. Another upcycled addition is the vintage Filipino armoire, refinished in ebony with hints of gold and is now used as a bar. Making our way up, we take notice of a wall that is clad with an antique mirror-like finish called verre églomissé. Exploring the second floor, we notice that each room captures the personality of the homeowners and their children. The boys' room is functional and practical. A pulley lamp and metal chairs introduce a subtle industrial theme. to maximize space in the little girl's room. The clever addition of a daybed makes it possible to enjoy a quick change from playroom to bedroom. The third bedroom has a quiet and restful appeal. The icy blue wall colors and the white accents are easy on the eye. A slatted wall panel was added to provide more privacy to the space. The master bedroom reminds us of a posh and relaxing hotel room. The high padded headboard and full drapes soften the dramatic color palette of the room. There's a desk for two to save on space, and a built-in wall unit at the foot of the bed is for the TV and extra storage.
I'm here with my good friend Tanya Frike in this gorgeous house that she designed. Tanya, hello.
Hello, Anton.
Why don't you tell me something about how you created this house?
Every time I come to this house, it feels like coming home for me. As this was my first project 7 years ago, it's special to me because I built it from ground up. I literally came, it was an empty lot, and my client said, okay, are you willing to do this? I took on the challenge and I just thought, okay, let's see and let's work this out. And so she gave me the brief at that point that she wanted a contemporary home. And that's what I tried to do.
So from 7 years to now,
yes.
Tell us about the design brief. I mean, did it change? Did it evolve?
Yes.
How did it transition to
yes.
how it looks now?
Well, from that time when she said contemporary luxe, I said, okay, that was playing safe at that time. You know, it's an easy to describe word. I just took it as that. But then I said, this time, why don't we add some boldness to it, some texture, some Filipino elements to it. Things that we could play together and mix together as different elements, making it more into a contemporary, eclectic home. And so I asked her, I said, are you willing to do that? Are you willing to do colors and textures? And she said, yes, I'm game. Let's do it. So that's why it evolved into this home today.
So would you say that every element and every little thing that you put in the home really reflects the personality of the homeowner?
Yes, I think so. Through the journey that we've had together for the last 7 years, in between that, I did some other projects for her, and so I got to know her more. I tried to reflect in this home elements that I felt also define her. I have a lot of oriental and I have a lot of gold. She likes gold, so I added a lot of gold into the home. That's what I try to do for each of my projects, make it a representation of my clients.
So I notice when you walk into the home, you see a lot of subtle and strong gestures of color.
Yes.
How do you conceive this in your head and say, these elements put together will work?
Well, I think for me, all these years that I've evolved also as a decorator, I think that taking those chances of putting these elements together and just being honest to myself about it and just working in my head that they will work. They may be totally different from each other, but it's all, I think, gut feel and instinct. It's been that way through the years.
So gut feel and instinct would be blue with burgundy, orange with
yes,
yellow.
I just thought, okay, we're gonna go bold this time. We're gonna do textures and let's just do it. I mean, blue and orange, I always like together because it's sunset. It's very warming. And that's, I think, basically why I played with those colors for this home.
So Tanya, was there like a particular piece in the design process that gave you that moment, you know, that thought process, then you'll say, this is it, this is what I'm gonna build from? Or did it all come together eventually after picking so many things?
It did come together after picking so many things, but the initial purchase that I had made 7 years ago, which was a gold, like a gilded mirror from Paris, was one of my favorite pieces then. And so with this time around, I decided to use that as an inspiration with the roundness of it. I chose other elements that would complement that initial mirror, which was round, and so I put a lot of solihia in the house to give it that airy feel. And I put a lot of mirrors to add light into the house for one wall to bounce against each other to just make the feel larger. Part of a designer's challenge, I think, is being able to use a lot of the things that you used then and be able to use them again as something totally new. So retrofitting, renovating, and moving things around. I cut some sofas from three-seaters, I made them into one-seaters. I added arms on some. I moved things from the attic to the basement. I changed the walls, added textures, added colors. Clients sometimes don't realize that it's their old thing, and then you say, hey, look, this is something, do you like it? And they're like, oh, where'd I buy that? And I said, it's old. And now it's gold. Like the dining table, for instance, was I had a black base before and I made it gold and, you know, things like that. So it's a challenge for me to be able to save you know, where I can save and spend where I need to spend. And I think for clients, they really appreciate that.
So let's talk about the experience, right? I mean, like, normally you decorate a place, you fix a place, and then you see it all done, and it's so rewarding.
Yes.
But do you think that you get the same feeling with retrofitting or just buying new things?
I think I get even a better feeling when I retrofit. You know, I challenge myself, and I just, it's a crazy idea in my head, and I tell myself, is this going to work? And I answer myself, and I think so. So when I see the results, then I'm like, oh my gosh, it's even better than something I had bought. But yes, of course, I do like buying new things, and it's always fun when I see a find that, you know, that is one of a kind sort of piece.
So let's get into detail with some of the items that you've put in the house, because, yes, you know, they're very artisan-like, and their finish is fabulous. Where do you get all these things?
You're gonna notice that there's a large mirror that's acidized. It has that old antique finish. So I like using Tata Montilla because of his silver leafing and his acid finish. So I respect him as an artist. Monica and Sandra Olandres are really good artisans as well. They retrofit old furniture and turn them into something totally new. Like the platera, it was just a boring old 1950s platera that we turned into something beautiful. I lit it up inside. I made it navy blue lacquer, matched it with a bar. So things like that. Those are my favorite pieces in the home.
What about color, Tanya? Tell me about the process of color. Like, how do you interject color into a home? Because, you know, a lot of people, initially, they'd go for a cleaner, more neutral palette,
yes,
right?
Yes.
White, beige.
Yes.
But when they see color, they're like, oh, wow. How do you convince your client, first and foremost? Mm-hmm. And then after, how do you use the color?
I always tell my client that color adds warmth to a home. It's good to play safe with neutrals all the time as a background, but adding color just gives it a totally different feel. It makes it more homey. I think that's what, when clients look at homes that I've done in the past, the first thing they say all the time is that, oh, it's so homey. It feels like it's been there forever. So I think that has a lot to do with color. And the colors I like to use are really depending on what the clients like. That I didn't used to do. I try to challenge myself every time to put colors together that I haven't put together before. So through wallpaper, a painted wall for instance, sponge painted wall, or texture over texture, pattern over pattern. I need to think of new, fresh ideas to make every work of mine different and yet the same in the sense that I did them.
So we've talked about the furniture, the elements, texture, color.
Yes.
How do you describe this home?
I would describe this home to be a contemporary, eclectic home. So a play with old and new textures, colors, retrofitting, staying true to the integrity of the house. As a designer, there are no design rules anymore. I personally go with gut feel and instinct, but at the same time, I can't just go crazy and put colors together out of nowhere. I still have to be true to the architecture, but at the same time, being coherent that everything still works together. No design rules, but at the same time, staying true to the architecture of the home.
Tanya, thank you so much for welcoming Metro Home into this wonderful project of yours.
Thank you so much, Anton, for having me and having me as a guest at your show. It's always wonderful to work with you.
Pleasure.
This home's design revolves around striking color combinations, signature wallpapers, and vibrant prints all tied together bring a fresh take to a classic home. Let's check it out. Right smack in the middle of the major city of Makati, we set out to explore our first living space. Emulating a New York Fifth Avenue apartment, the elevator opens right into the foyer. Once we enter the unit, we instantly get a burst of color, not to mention the Degourné wallpaper, all revolving around a conservatory theme. The living room hosts a lot of seating, bold prints, and the aerial carpet, all enjoyed with a great view of the Rockwell skyline as a backdrop. As we move to the dining room, we can take notice of the very elegant style of chairs, and again, we see more of the same vibrant color combination used. I love the repeated play on prints in the foyer, from the furniture, the window treatment, to the wallpaper. And now, the master's bedroom. Take notice of how the wall was treated. The motif of the wallpaper reinforces the garden theme of the home, which contrasts with the tall, dramatic, tufted headboard. The aqua and taupe color combination is fitting for this relaxing space. The mixing of prints and patterns, plus the tasteful combination of vibrant colors, pull together to create a real chic city living space. The second bedroom has a playful mix of geometric designs. Behind the bed, there is a cutout pattern layered over mirrors. The neutral tones carry over, but this time are freshened up by a muted aqua. We continue to experience chic city living as we explore the guest room. A subdued color palette is noticeable, as well as a collection of botanical frames. Set up with two single beds and its own sitting area, this guest room is an easy invite. Behind the design of this beautiful apartment is Atelier El Mario. I'm here with Cynthia today. Cynthia, welcome.
Hi, Steph.
Thanks for being here.
Oh, it's my pleasure.
It's such a beautiful apartment, and the first thing I noticed walking in was this beautiful wallpaper.
Oh my God, yes. It's my all-time favorite, the Garnier print, and it's really very bespoke and artisanal because we had to actually choose a background color, which happens to be silk. And then we had to approve even the hand painting.
Wow. I'm sure it takes time because, like you said, artisanal.
Was this
like the foundation of the design of the home?
This is where I extract all my colors. So if you can see, it also kind of gave it a very conservative garden feel to the place.
Because
unfortunately, one of the downsides of this layout is you enter right away into a living room.
However, it is very Fifth Avenue with a foyer in the front.
Yeah, in the elevator. So
beautiful.
That's what I went with.
I also noticed in the front, actually, as soon as you enter you have this beautiful play of the repeated prints.
Yes.
Right? So on the furniture upholstery, the window treatment, and the wallpaper.
Yeah, I just had to keep it simple because it was a small space.
Yes.
And I wanted to enlarge the space by doing just one print. So wherever your eyes travel, just see one print and it's so cohesive.
So that makes the space bigger,
Yes, just use one print.
Fantastic. So tell me a little bit more about the striking color combinations, because that's something that wows the people walking into this home.
This is very unexpected, our choice of the carpet, because it's very modern.
Yes.
Whereas this is very lyrical.
Correct.
Yeah, so it was kind of hard to find this sofa fabric because it had to match my wallpaper, the other wallpaper that would surround the units. And then I had to introduce the stripes as well, just to give some geometry to the space.
Yes.
I didn't notice I painted this green lacquer.
Okay, so what was the original color of that chair?
Nothing. I mean, it was a custom chair.
Okay.
Yeah, and then normally we just do it white, or we just do it walnut.
Neutral colors. Wood tones.
But you know how like Jonathan Adler is? I mean, he paints all his furniture lacquer.
So you wanted a pop of black.
I wanted a pop because I really wanted, as soon as you enter, that it's still an extension of the garden.
I see.
Yeah, because this is like my anteroom, and then we moved to the living room. That's the story.
And I love how, you know, they are distinct spaces, but there is so much continuity.
Yeah,
it's really beautiful how you continue the colors and yet made the space different and distinct. What are the differences between the two spaces? This would be a more formal, like, welcome city, whereas this would really be where the client hosts.
This one is just really like where guests will be seated first before they are called to go to the living or the dining room.
Okay.
So it's actually the reverse. This is more casual for me.
Okay.
Because of the garden setting.
Yes.
And then I tried to make that more formal.
Exactly, with more geometric. I love the tufted sofa. That's really also another focal point in the living room. But what beautiful textures, like just layered one over another. I see you have a great knack for layering things, and you love contrasting colors and these striking colors. And that's where I wanted to ask you a little bit more about the home, because the living spaces are so vibrant. And I love the textures and the play on colors. What did you do, and what was your inspiration for the bedrooms? How would you compare that?
Again, I had a DNA as a starting point for the master's bedroom, because the owner actually, she's fun. She's like, oh, I like this. And then the other rooms, it becomes more like our signature style, which is stone and tone. So the other two bedrooms has a kind of like a taupe and
actually, I loved how you still had the geometric pattern theme going on, but it was muted.
Yes, you see,
which was so fitting for a relaxing space.
Oh yeah, because normally a lot of people forget about the bedrooms.
Mm-hmm.
They only take care of things that they see, like the living spaces. But for me, it's the other way around. I really take care of bedrooms because for me, that's where they stay the longest.
Both appreciate our beauty sleep, I'm sure.
So sure.
That's so important. Yeah. I completely agree with that.
Yeah, and I always tell my clients, guys, you gotta spend money in your bedroom. You gotta get the best mattress because you sleep 8 hours, 10 hours.
Exactly.
Really? I mean, that's really the return on investment right away, right there.
Yes.
And then I said, use the best sheets. Use everything that's wonderful in your bedroom because that's the first thing you see in the morning.
So I love how you give tips to your clients. Can you just expound a little bit on how, you know, the process is? You have a vision, like you said, you have a DNA, you start with your DNA.
Right, right.
Your signature DNA. But then how do you incorporate what the client wants, like their lifestyle or specific choices?
So for this particular client, she wanted a garden feel. So the Dicornay became my DNA. I was able to introduce a lot of textures and patterns.
Yes, so you have repeated floral.
Yes.
From the wallpaper to the throw pillows, and then you add some geometric in the rug.
Okay. So I was able to introduce it by using this Shinmasuri chair. And because of that, I was able to use this very nice vase.
It's fantastic how you go really to the detail,
right,
even with the accessories and the styling. Tell me, is that what you prefer in the whole process?
Yeah, yeah.
Is that
it's
really
my favorite.
Your thing?
And it's like easy for me because I love creating vignettes. So when I saw this pagoda, they only had one. I was like, order it, please. Come on, order another one. I need a pair. So we had to wait for it.
You know, speaking of how you were looking for pairs,
yes,
I also noticed that there's a lot of symmetry and mirroring in your style.
Yes.
I noticed that as well in the dining room in the back.
Right.
And why do you, is that a signature Almario trait or?
Actually, it's just interior design 101, I guess. What happens to the right should happen to the left. You know what I'm saying?
I think the mirroring and the symmetry also gives us some sort of harmonious feel.
Yeah, like feng shui. It's a very good feng shui because there's balance, there's symmetry, and there's order.
So we've touched on striking color combinations, prints, and layering. Cynthia, why don't you give us a tip on how people can use color?
Okay, I always say that everyone has a color that makes them smile. Because there's certainly a color for each and every person in the world. Just make sure that when you commit to a color, commit fully. Don't do, pink, okay. Blush, like the lightest pink. No, if you say green, it's green. If it's blue, it's blue. And then you start playing with combinations. That's when everything soars. That's when all the magic happens, when you combine colors.
I love that. Be bold, choose it, and do it wholeheartedly,
exactly,
right? Thank you so much, Cynthia, for your time and all your insight in this beautiful home in the heart of Makati.
My pleasure.
Today we explore Oz Gallery, a unique family-owned boutique that takes in vintage finds and breathes new life into them. From starting out doing faux finishes on walls in private homes, this couple started venturing into furniture. They started by making their own custom mirrors and chandeliers.
Let's check out some of the amazing pieces from Sandro and Monica Laundries. This vertical mirror is gilded and has a more traditional carving at the top. It makes for an opulent and elegant piece to add to any room. The black horizontal mirror, on the other hand, is a casual chic piece because of the French rub technique used. I truly appreciate the workmanship behind it.
These handmade chandeliers are all unique and impressive. Some are more elegant with traditional beading. My favorite has tassels and faux tortoise capiche shells and is dressed with abaca lampshades. One is more casual and resort-like because of the naturally rough-edged capiche detail. This would hang perfectly in a seaside villa. These pair of Nara table lamps are hand-painted by Sandro himself. They have an interesting contrast of color and finishing techniques. While these table lamps have a distressed look, they sit on a sleek metal base which makes them the perfect transitional piece. The Pina floor lamps are absolutely eye-catching. They have a combination of a distressed finish on the base paired with statement metal leaves that are gilded in gold and copper finishes which glisten with the light. The largest floor lamp in the showroom is another statement piece. Its base is a hand-carved candelabra in a putty finish and a glowing linen shade. The 70s design amber lamp is an interesting vintage touch in Oz Gallery. I adore how they modernized it with the light-colored fabric. This vintage Chinese telephone table has a two-tone lacquer finish to give it a modern look. It is a piece that is sure to bring nostalgia to your home. El Botiquin is an old pharmacist's table that was revamped in antique red. The aqua glass handle is the perfect touch to make this a statement piece in your living room.
I can sit on this plush chair all day. Designer Jamie Tan calls it the shawl chair. It's upholstered with this deep emerald velvet. It has beautiful pleats, and this accent brass piping is just the perfect touch to add the chic opulence to it. He also uses this faux horn in the back, and believe it or not, it is a three-legged chair.
This antique is a wooden resting chair you would commonly see in train stations in India. It is finished in black with a French rub technique, a classic Asian version of today's lazy boy. This Nara cabinet is an ode to mid-century Filipino design. The semi-circular wood carving is a special detail above the glass-paneled door. The Oz cocktail table is a signature piece that merges form and function. The mirrored back panel, lights, and pull-out cabinet features make it the perfect addition to anyone's dining room.
It is truly inspiring to see the creative ideas this couple brings to each and every piece they restore or create. Check out the Oz Gallery at LRI Design Plaza on Nicanor Garcia Street, Makati.
From houseware to furniture, their showroom is a one-stop shop for buyers seeking reasonable and quality choices.
A family business founded in the 60s, Crate & Barrel was inspired by simple and well-balanced things discovered during a trip to Europe by its founders. Today, the brand continues to expand in countries around the world while making sure to stay true to their mission of providing quality and practical designs.
This is the Stowe Ottoman from Crate & Barrel. It's upholstered in leather, it's got nice stitching detail, and it's really easy to use. Let me show you. When decorating with an ottoman, this makes for easy storage because it's got this wide and gracious pocket here where you can put in a lot of things. So if you do it in your bedroom, for example, or in your living room, then you can just put it in any space or any corner, and you can tuck away like throw pillows, you can tuck away like little blankets and books. So decorating with ottomans is really easy. All you have to do is put it around the house, and it makes for easy seating and storage. This is the Vintner chair. It's a really great piece to use around the house because it's so versatile. Its classic silhouette with the X detail is very, very easy for any look. You can use it in a more formal setting if you want to mix it with like upholstered chairs or leather chairs for that nice mix of furniture around your house. And you can use it in the office or in the bedroom. I would use it really maybe in a more casual setting like in a kitchen so that it adds a lot of pop and color to the whole space. So if you want to add that welcoming pop of color in your room, here we have the peacock one, the dove gray, black, and the red. So we're here in Crate & Barrel in the rug section where we have racks of beautiful carpets that you can choose from. There's an easy tip here. When you decorate a room, make sure not to forget a carpet because the carpet will always anchor the space and keep all your furniture together. It unifies the space. So, tip one, choose wisely with regards to color and texture. Keep to the color scheme of your room, and if you want to add some color, then that's where you can go. Pops of color through the carpet and maybe the throw pillows. Here we have the Ariza carpet, which is really great in detail. It's got this E-cut pattern and nice tone on tone. We have dark beige, a light beige mixed with gray, and this really, really pleasant ivory. It makes for a good background for any color. Moving up here, we have a plain colored carpet, but if you notice, it's woven with a very pleasant and light blue. There's a bit of green that I see. This kind of carpet will add texture more than anything else. Because of its really random pattern that you have, you can put anything that's neutral on top of it. Ooh, check out this Alvi spring rug. It's got really nice pattern, circular, good for feng shui. But if you look at it, See how the contrasting colors work together. You have the orange, the light yellows, a dove gray. All of these colors unify and will really, really give detail and attention to this rug. Moving on to these racks, if you notice, we have the plain carpets. So these plain carpets will really define your space. Its cool colors will really, really give your room a great posh feeling. Look at this one. It's got a lot of texture, and I love this detail where it disappears here over the edge. And the little cubes give it a graphic look, which is like really cool. If you want to see, Crate & Barrel really provides us with a lot of choices. Because if you think about carpets, they have one that's indoor and outdoor use. So this friendly Saatchi carpet can go in your patio, terrace, or maybe even beside the pool in your deck. The colors are so bright and really, really nice to look at. This is the Gia sofa, which probably reminds us of the 1950s, where this retro vibe was going. I would use it in the bedroom or maybe a man cave. The details of this Gia sofa has this really disciplined line of button-down tufting, and it's got this really gracious curve here that swoops down and makes it look soft. Here we have the Davis sofa that's upholstered in leather. It's like really smooth, cool, and comfortable. I like leather. When using leather in an interior scape, it adds a different kind of softness as opposed to what you have when you do fabric. This sofa would look good in the living room, especially because it's got really clean lines so you can mix it with anything and everything. Aside from the living room, you'd maybe want to put this in the bedroom because then it will work good with all the textures that you have. So when you talk about color and texture, introducing leather would balance everything out because normally in the bedroom, you'd have a lot of soft textures from the pillows, the comforter, the curtain. So leather just adds a different dimension and texture. If you've got a man cave in your house, this is definitely the piece that you'd want to use. Elevate your viewing experience when you're watching your favorite movie or TV show and listening to the tunes that you really enjoy. This is the Blake Tall Cabinet, a really easy piece to use around your house. I'd put it initially, the living room or the dining room, but a good idea would be to use it in your bathroom. The open shelving will provide versatile use for folded towels. The exposure of it all will make it easy for you to see things right away. And the natural mix of materials provides an interesting texture. Look at this matting. It's got brass handles, and the color of the wood will seamlessly mix and integrate itself into any interior space. Another interesting feature of the Blake Tall Cabinet is the adjustable shelves. You can move them up and down to create space for whatever you have to display. So if you're enjoying the bar and cocktail scene in the metro, maybe you want to skip out in the busy and crowded places and head on to Crate & Barrel and get yourself one of these bars. They're easy and convenient to use around your home. This vertical setup has all the necessary compartments that you want to have for an easy and convenient bar. It's got racks, a drawer, and some shelves. Now this piece might be of interest to you. It's a two-door bar cabinet system, which gives you all the necessary compartments to enjoy your bar. The drawer for the accessories, the rack for the stemware. It's got all these shelves for different sizes of glasses and the bottles. It's got a bottle rack, some shelves for easy storage, and it's got a nice brace in the shelving system so that things don't fall over. Here's the Galvin table. It's another piece that shows off texture. Its metal top and mango wood base gives it the balance that you need when you talk about texture in a home. This table can be used indoor and outdoor. Dress it up and add a bit of color with the use of different colored chairs and maybe that carpet that we saw a while ago, that Saatchi carpet that's great for outdoor use. Crate & Barrel isn't just about furniture. They've got an extensive line of houseware and kitchen accessories, like these bowls, mixing pots, containers, and they've even got appliances that you really, really need.
Visit Crate & Barrel, located at SM Makati, SM Megamall, and SM Aura.